We never seen all these PC DJ tunes as these big, huge tunes that are, everybody knows. It's just a mess of it. It was never anything serious.
DJ fucking bad boy here, streaming a shite. About to tell you a story about my Friday night.
I get a lot of people come up to me and say you're a big part of my childhood and I listen to this and I listen to that and it still doesn't really sink in.
I was meant to be going to Dusk 20 minutes ago, then I heard DJ Bad Boys in Foot Bar. Get me there.
Yeah, it's like a staple growing up in Scotland.
I believe a multi-genre event which brings back the nostalgia of the PC DJ era mixed with a bit of today. It's still alive, it's probably bigger than it was even back then. It started from a drunken, mad idea.
One night he said, why don't we do a nostalgia night?
Get ranking Jammy McKeef, DJ Bad Boy. And I was like, no one has ever ran a night with all these DJs about nostalgia.
Sold 450 tickets in a 350 capacity event. Different places all in Scotland got a hold of us. The Bucky, never heard a Bucky in my life, just thought it was a drink. Obviously shout out to DJ Bad Boy here.
At first you were kind of, what is going on here, man? All these people are going bonkers. So it was literally just speeding songs up and putting random stuff in and hoping for the best.
Definitely a Scottish-based thing, and when I was younger, it was all I was interested in. I had all the Cathy Hardcore CDs, I had all that, and I just think probably that influenced me.
There was always that song that everyone would play and it'd be like, Gary McKay.
On MSN, I would make a song and then put the link up on, just saying download the link. And that was basically how my songs went out to people. It would end up on things like madweight-1.com and all these kind of websites. That was like the PC DJ websites.
Upload it to Bebo, or you would go to MSN and then people would download it off LimeWire or Infrared when you used to put the phones together.
And then these shocking speakers that people had seen, or Sony Ericsson speakers, they'd hang one for one side and one for the other. It was actually DJ Rankin, I would probably say, that inspired me. When I was like 13, he was like the first on the scene.
But they always say to me, like, oh, you started it, but we all had our own touch on it, do you know what I mean? Like, I started it and it was maybe kind of basic, and then somebody would take it, like Paul took it and made it better. And then Gary came in and it was just like influenced and it just go better and better and better, do you know what I mean? So we've all had a part in it, man.
I sure thought it was like Italian Euro music, and off the back of learning how to do these kind of songs, we actually turned it into a genre of its own.
Most people are coming for all the old tunes because you can't beat the old stuff, but because there's new stuff thrown in, mate, as well, it's just like, then you don't know what you're getting on the night, it's just a bit of everything. They know it, see, as soon as you hit play on that deck, people start screaming, regardless if it's me, Cammy, if it's Gary or Paul. As soon as they hear a tune from back in the day, they know it as soon as you press play, they know that first second of the song and they just go bonkers.
It's all coming back, do you know what I mean? It's like, the bouncier stuff's getting popular again.
The clientele, the majority is 18 to 24 now. We went from a brand that originally was aimed at you're coming here to like relive your youth, and now the youth are actually wanting to be a part of this.
I've always really looked up to Isla Riva. I don't think a lot of people know that, but I feel like we are like a big family, and I feel like I really do fit into them. Like, I love all the boys to bits.
To think this is my job, my livelihood, my career, my brand that I built from nothing, it's an amazing feeling. And, like I said, I think this is just a start.
This is it!